boy. Hi, Mary McKnight from Service Dog Academy and Diabetic Alert Dog University. This is Q&A Tuesday, and each week we're gonna start you off with a socialization item. And this week's socialization item is a feather boa. As you can see, Liam's pretty interested in this item. He thinks it's a toy, and that's kind of what most dogs do. So although you may not have a lot of feather boas in your local neighborhood, you might see them here in Seattle or in any large big city that you go to. So try and get your dog used to the fact that something strange that looks like a toy might be hanging from your neck or other body parts, so that when your dog sees something like this on a person, they don't go ballistic in a socialization setting. So our first question comes from, I believe it's Steven. Steven writes, I'm on the phone with my insurance company to see if there would be an option to partially bill or bill all of the cost of training a diabetic alert dog. They were wondering if there is a medical procedure code for dog training that I could supply them. Steven, this is a really good question, and it's a question that's asked by a lot of our students. Actually, it's pretty much asked by every one of our students. So unfortunately, even poorly trained diabetic alert dogs tend to reduce hospitalization, ER visits, calls to paramedics, unfortunately, insurance companies just aren't covering diabetic alert dog training at all. Even my most successful students who saw the paramedics 8, 10, 12 times a year prior to getting their diabetic alert dog, who have now not seen the paramedics since they got them, they can't even get their insurance company to cover this, what they can term alternative therapy. So additionally, the fact there's only been one scientific study to prove the efficacy of a diabetic alert dog has not really helped our cause. But don't let the lack of scientific evidence scare you. The thing is that it's been scientifically proven that dogs can smell cancer, and that they can find drugs. And these things have held up in both state and federal court. So I think it's only a matter of time until we have scientific evidence that diabetic alert dogs are actually doing what they say they are. I know that you're probably asking this question because of the concern of a cost of a trained diabetic alert dog, or the cost of training might be prohibitive for you. But the thing is that we have found with proper fundraising techniques, of which we can show you, the cost of a diabetic alert dog to you personally can sometimes be less than the cost of an emergency room visit. So my recommendation, give us a call. And if you're seriously interested in our diabetic alert dog training, fill out an application and we will get you on the wait list. And I promise you, it's probably not gonna be as much as you think it is. Good luck, and we look forward to helping you, Stephen. If you have a question for Q&A Tuesday, email us at questions@servicedogacademy.com and we will try to answer them in our next episode. If you would like to learn more about our diabetic alert dog training videos or medical alert dog training classes, please contact us at info@servicedogacademy.com. And don't forget, we can come to your state to do a diabetic alert dog class. If you can gather at least 4 students in your area, we will fly out to your location and teach our 4-day intensive diabetic alert dog class, just like we did in Denver, Colorado this year. We have a class coming up this December, December 19th through the 21st, and registration information is available at servicedogacademy.com. We're looking forward to seeing you there.